What do you think the best argument for atheism is?
Well, if it isn't Zordon Power Rangerson, or whatever the hell his name is. Hey, you can't tell me he doesn't sound exactly the same. Anyway, he's being asked what he thinks the best argument for atheism is. Well, this ought to be interesting. Although notice I didn't say smart, or correct, or even reflective of something that is a fucking argument, or anything of the sort. Just that it would be interesting. But you know, car crashes are interesting too. Doesn't mean you want to be stuck in the middle of one. And yeah, I still play in traffic. God damn, man. I mean, it's good to think about a question when you have never been asked it before, but you talk to atheists all the time. How could you possibly have never considered this before? Like, seriously, it's like being a competitive eater and not knowing what your favorite food is off the top of your head.
I don't think there is a good argument for atheism.
Well, damn, that's not even an answer to the question, and is incredibly intellectually lazy. He didn't ask you what you think the one good argument for atheism is, or what a good argument even is. He asked you what the best is. Even if all the arguments for atheism were total dog shit, you know, like how all the arguments for theism are, I would still be able to determine which I thought was the closest to being a good argument, or the one that's the least dog shit. But no, you can't even give us that, either because you weren't listening, or you really are as stupid as the toilet wall people said you were. What, you want to hear it? Couldn't possibly repeat something so thoroughly erotic.
I think it's based on a fundamental misunderstanding about the nature of the world.
So, you think that? Goddamn real, yeah? That's how not being an atheist works, Jordan. I think that people who do believe in God have a fundamental misunderstanding about the nature of the world. They think that a God exists. Christ, how do people actually think this guy has fucking anything to contribute? I mean, I'm a fucking moron, and I can see how vapid almost everything he says about religion is. It's fucking embarrassing.
So, it's just, okay. It's what would you say? It's an illegal chess move.
Okay.
Not buying the claims of theists is an illegal chess move. I'm not allowed to be unconvinced of the frankly ridiculous bullshit constantly being spouted by people who demand that I believe in their nonsensical shit. Yeah, sounds about right. I mean, the amount of times I have heard that atheists do actually believe in God, we just, I don't know, pretend not to because we want to do X, Y, Z, even though breaking the God rules usually results in some kind of terrible punishment. So why the fuck would we do that? Well, I'll say it's not uncommon.
Well, it's based on the wrong...
This might just show that I don't understand you, but we'll get to it if I don't.
My God, he really doesn't have anything, does he? It's based on the wrong trails off. No, what? I want to know, Jordan. My fundamental lack of belief in the claims that I find unconvincing. What exactly have I misunderstood? Because I'm pretty sure I understand the arguments as they have been presented. And if they are better than I think they are, well, your lot is just shit at conveying them then. How exactly is that my fault? Maybe y'all should get good, eh?
The best argument for atheism.
What's the best of the worst arguments?
Materialistic determinism is the best argument for atheism.
What the actual f***? That's not a good argument for atheism. That's not a bad argument for atheism. That is not a fucking argument for anything, Jordan. Even the stupidest theists I have ever interacted with, and that is a number so big that it makes even my penis look downright reasonable, wouldn't call that worldview a fucking argument. Man, I knew the guy was a meme, but I didn't realize he was an actual idiot. Christ.
But isn't that a philosophical sort of assumption or axiom?
That's a problem.
Yeah.
Oh, fuck me. Are you kidding me? I mean, good on interview man for pointing out that his answer was stupid, you know, without saying it. But no way he wasn't thinking it real loud. But Geordie Boy's response is so weaselly. Like, seriously. Yeah, it is a problem for you that you have demonstrated that you are either not listening to anything that is being said or that you are just too fucking stupid / ignorant to be having this conversation. And yeah, both of them are huge problems because either you don't fucking listen to people and thus why should anyone listen to you, or you aren't equipped for the conversations you choose to engage in. So maybe, you know, you shouldn't. Or, you know, you could just be better, but I don't see that happening.
Like, for me, I think it would be, if this, and let's just choose the Christian God, if he exists and wants me to know him and save me, wouldn't he make it easier?
I don't know if that's a strong atheist argument, but sure, fine. It's something better than fucking Jordan has come up with. And yeah, a God that wants you to know them. I mean, that practically demands it on pain of, you know, pain, but like forever. And yet is awfully sneaky with all of those world hide-and-seek championship trophies still waiting on him to pick them up, by the way. It does seem odd that he claims to want one thing and then does something completely non-existent.
Why does he make it so difficult? Why does he seem to hide?
Because you have something to do.
My non-existo, is he always this fucking defensive? All of his answers have been this short clapback style of reply, even with all these pauses. It's like buckshot. And something to do? Are you saying that God wants us to do something? Well, that doesn't actually fix the problem, because his hiding still means that I don't know what the thing he needs me to do is. And no, pretending that I already believe in him in order to cause some psychological problems in my own brain that trick me into believing something that I actually don't really isn't a good thing to do. If anything, it makes it all the more obvious that the guy doesn't actually exist.
Okay. You have something important to do. It's no game. The price of life is death. It's not a game.
Jordan, 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 I know another Jordan. He's big and he's blue and he talks almost as much shit as you do. Fuck, if I didn't know any better, I could see you being the fucking guy, but no. Unfortunately, there is more than one word salad equals deep philosopher mathematical point guy out there. The price of life is death. No, the result of life is death. The price of life is a nice meal, two bottles of Prosecco, and a Barry White album. Everybody knows this.
Right? There's evil, too. You have something to do. It's not easy. In fact, it'll take everything you have.
But atheismo forbid I say it instead of alluding to some thing with my big book of vaguely McVegason's vague statements for people who don't actually have shit worth saying, but want to sound like they do to people who are assuming that I'm smart when what I am is tantamount to a fucking cold reader. Well, you see, your problem is you've got sober. Yeah, I'm sober. Yes, that's what I was going to say. The spirits told me. The spirits tell me all. This one says, drink me.
Everything. Right, that's why you're to consecrate everything to God. This isn't, you're not an infant.
Well, apparently you are, because all this shit is the most infantile response I can think of. Again, you aren't actually answering anything this guy has said, and you aren't even making anything clear that you have already alluded to. And it is frankly baffling that there is anyone left that takes you seriously anymore.
But you're not being treated by God like an infant. You're being treated by God like
responsible moral agent. He doesn't just want comfortable little pets and his...
Okay. Here's an argument for atheism. If God was real, you would stop interrupting the guy constantly so he can never even come close to finishing a single thought. And no, just because I interject, it's not the same thing. Jordan only doesn't finish his thoughts because he barely fucking starts them.
To be made in the image of God is to be someone who wrestles with potential.
Okay, fine. Let's say that's true. Prove it. Prove that that is a true thing that is expected of me from an entity that actually exists and that is something that they want. You can't, obviously, because it's not true. And to address the God doesn't want pets or whatever bit, do you guys have any fucking concept of what it means to be an infinite being? The idea that the best a human could be, the most enlightened and smart and all that shit that we are allegedly supposed to do, comparing us to animals is giving way too much fucking credit. You would be lucky to be as to a trained dog next to an infinite being. You are nothing next to him. Even the ant analogy simply doesn't work. Even the idea of you being bacteria does not work. Humans are to God as the infinite nothing between particles of the smallest element are to us, except way less important to him than that shit could ever be, because we at least think about it sometimes.
To genuinely
wrestle with potential.
That's right.
Okay.
Well, that's the tohu vabohu that exists at the beginning of time.
Tovi vovi vu, or whatever the fuck he said. If I hadn't decided to look that up and see that it's a real thing, I would have sworn he just devolved into making random mouth noises in place of actually making coherent, you know, ish points at us. Because, well, you know, it wouldn't be surprising if that was what just happened.
Right, the potential, the watery chaos.
Okay.
The spirit of God sits above the chaos, the primordial chaos.
You know what? That sounds like a load of old made-up wank to me. But apparently I'm not allowed to think that, even though that's clearly what it is, seeing as the beginnings of the universe don't sound anything like what we understand to have happened, for one, and that even if we had no idea, it still doesn't sound anything other than completely made up. But that's just me and my fundamental misunderstanding of, I don't know, he won't tell us, but it's not how fucking facts work, I'll tell you that for free.
And extracts order out of that. That's what you do as a conscious agent.
Sit above the watery chaos and extract order out of it. I don't know what the fuck you have been smoking, mate, but that's not descriptive of what anybody does. And you might say, well, you know, I'm being metaphorical. Well, that's just fucking great. But how about you try to say something that's actually true instead of that? And then maybe I might fucking believe you.
And you do that. You do that in a way that is aimed towards hell or aimed towards heaven. Really?
Okay, but wouldn't it be super useful if I could, I don't know, detect those things? These paths are invisible trails that are frankly consisting of some very different outcomes, although personally I think neither of them is actually appealing. So what would also be great is if I could consciously aim away from any of them, so I don't have to exist for fucking ever, considering both sound like eternal torture to me. But that is only because I have actually considered the dire consequences of forever, instead of just thinking, but me, I'm too important to die for always.
But you wouldn't think people who claim to be atheists are necessarily irrational?
All right, finally time for him to walk back some of the arrogant and stupid shit that he said and prove that he actually knows something about a group of people that he spends countless hours debating on stage and various other platforms, and to say something that isn't completely fucking asinine. Right? Right? Right?
They're perfectly rational if you accept the initial axiom, but I don't accept the initial axiom.
And neither do we, you fucking sponge. That whole materialist whatever garbage was your completely unthought out non-argument that you think atheists is the strong argument of, because you are so fucking stupid you couldn't even come out with something that was definitionally accurate, let alone a good example of one. How is this man more famous than me? I'm stupid too. I say idiotic shit as well. But that's it, isn't it? I actually have some humility. I know that I'm a fucking moron, and I explain when I don't know things. When I don't know what the fuck I'm talking about. I need to stop being so honest and start just making up shit and pretending that it's true. And when it's pointed out that I it up, pretend some more that it's actually the fault of the straw man that he's so flammable, and not because I dosed him with oil when I built him.
Which is, so, what's the original?
Like I said, it's something like a materialist determinism.
Yeah.
No.
First accurate thing he said, and he didn't even mean it that way. And the guy was working so hard to try and make sordid Petersburg not sound dumb, but he's missed an important thing. He's an idiot. He has no idea what he's talking about, but is 100% convinced that he knows something that the rest of us don't. That's why he's so confident, and yet can barely string a sentence together on the subject.
First of all, whatever matter is, and we certainly don't understand it, it doesn't look at all like something deterministic at the highest level of resolution.
What is resolution in this instance? It's a word that sounds like he's saying something smart, but is he going to actually define it? No. Definitions are for people who have things of value to say. James Corden without the charm does not do that, unless he's defining something, you know, incorrectly.
Mm-hmm. There's something very weird going on down there at the quantum level, you know, and what the philosophical implications of that are, you know, God only knows.
Well, of course you would bring up quantum. I told you the guy's just spirit science without the cartoon. But, you know, I hate to do it. He does have the funny voice. Everything he does and says is just the same as all of those fuckers. From your Deepak Chopras to your, of course, spirit science, to your insert any number of wacky bullshit merchants here.
But there's no easy determinism in the physical realm.
There is no easy determinism. Well, I know it's not even worth asking, but what do you mean by easy? I mean, for argument's sake, if the universe is just a series of physical and chemical reactions, and that's all there is to it, then a universe where everything is causally inevitable is just kind of how it would be. The only reason people tend to think that that's not the case is because they feel like it's not the case. Because, you know, free will seems to be a thing, but you need more than just... It seems to me that my actions are entirely my own in order to prove that. You have to, like, prove that. I know, it's shocking, isn't it?
So anybody who claims that is, like, stuck in what, in the world of Newton. They're, like, in 1830.
Look, Jordan, maybe, I don't know, but then I don't consider myself a strict determinist. Does it seem reasonable to assume that the physics axiom, every action has an equal and opposite reaction, holds true? Sure, but I don't know. There could be more to this universe that I am not seeing. I'm perfectly happy for that to be the case, but you're the one that's telling us what we definitely think, or at least that that worldview is the best argument, when that's not even a real sentence. The fact of the matter is, I'm not convinced that you even know what atheists are, let alone what any of our fucking arguments could be. And the fact that you've spent so much time talking about it whilst being so bad at it is just fucking depressing.
What if the person just says, all right, I'm open to believing in God or not believing in God, and I've seen no good evidence or arguments for God's existence?
It's like I said, it's an illegal game move.
Well, fuck me. Evidence. You can't have it.
Because it's devastating to my case.
Well, I'm sorry that you having to prove things you believe makes you so sad. But unless you do, I'm not going to believe you or anything you fucking say, you absolute joke of a deep thinker. Christ, he's about as deep as a fucking cum splash.
Wait, before you go, I have something super important to tell you. It's life or death. It will change everything forever. Nope. Wait, it's gone. Oh well, probably wasn't important. But while I have you, don't forget to comment, subscribe, and notify. And if you want more of my smexy voice, check out Mrs. Six's channel, Spoonstaff Stories, where I narrate and voice all the videos. And she does the work. And if you want to support the channel, check out the merch store for cool t-shirts, or check out Patreon, memberships, and PayPal to support directly. Finally, follow me on the medias of social to get completely pointless guff and to keep up on the latest releases. Oh, I just remembered what I was going to tell you. Whatever you do, don't touch the...